Theology of the Body was St. John Paul the Great's response to the sexual revolution of the 1970s and, overall, a response to the world's shift on sin. In a series of 129 short talks, the philosophy behind the program was recorded, organized, and spread throughout the world. The program's name is based on the word theology, which comes from the Greek root theos, which means God, and suffix ology, which means the study of. So combining the two, theology means the study of God. St. John Paul the Great noticed that a person could greatly learn to study God through his or her body. His teachings connect to an important question that many people have at some point of their lives. What is my purpose in life? Do you have any idea? His writings led to a simplification of the question. What one word shows my purpose in life? Are you thinking? Even simpler yet, it becomes a fill-in-the-blank activity. My purpose is to be in blank with God. Do you know it? Here's a clue, and maybe it was your answer. Some people think this is an image of heaven. But St. John Paul the Great wanted us to look at the now and not the future, so heaven isn't the answer. Here's another clue. Can you tell what's going on in this picture? It's a representation of the church triumphant, church militant, and church suffering all coming together during Mass. This moment is known as the consecration, but that's still not the answer, but it's a clue as it's about to happen next. The answer? That's right. My purpose is to be in communion with God. Yes, this happens in heaven, but why wait until then? Start now and make it a goal for every moment and a highlight for your week, receiving the Sunday Eucharist. St. John Paul the Great goes further and says, in order to truly understand ourselves, we must look to three different things. Do you have any ideas on what they are? We must look to our origin, history, and destination. These are words you probably recognize from school. Let's look at them one by one. The first one is a word that is common in math, and you may remember it as being 0.00 on a graph, also known as the starting point. Well, St. John Paul the Great wants us to look at the starting point of our own existence, which provides some pretty interesting information. Before the earth was created, we had just God, namely just God the Father. And since God the Father does not have a body, this is not an accurate representation, but we will use it for the example here. God the Father was so full of love that another was created out of him, and that creation was God the Son. The action word you may recognize from the Nicene Creed as begotten, as Jesus the Son was created from the Father. Well, the love between the Father and the Son back and forth was so great, and that love became a communion, with one giving and the other receiving, and vice versa. This communion love was so great that it could not contain itself in this exchange and exploded outward, causing a new creation. You may be thinking ahead here and know exactly what is coming next. This creation became none other than the Holy Spirit, the third person of the Holy Trinity. And this is why the St. John Paul the Great states that God is an exchange of love, and that God creates out of love. Think about it. When was the last time you created something for another person? There's a good chance it could have been a birthday card, gift, or project. What is this creation made from? That's right, love. This is how God operates. So, think back to the story you're familiar with, the creation of the world. Do you remember the six stages, the 6 days? On that last day, God made his ultimate creation, and that was man. We don't know exactly what it would have looked like, but here's a possibility. God took dirt from the ground and used it to create the body of a man and then blew into it a spirit. As a result, The human person is made up of two parts, the visible, which is the body, and the invisible, which is the soul. Now, here is another question which might sound familiar. Where does the invisible become visible? Here is another clue. Hint, there are seven of them. And this is what happens during each. You receive it. Yes, they are the seven sacraments. According to the Catechism, the definition of a sacrament is an outward sign of God's grace. And through them, the sacraments make the invisible become visible. Now, St. John Paul the Great noticed something very interesting. He noticed that there was something else that was like a sacrament, so he referred to it as the eighth sacrament. Do you have any idea on what he meant? He states that the body could be considered as the eighth sacrament. And the reason why, we can use our body to express God. Our bodies can express the outward signs of God's grace. Our bodies can make the invisible nature of God become visible. Now, think of that as a gift and as an honor. Have you ever really thought about that? That your body should be used to express God? It makes sense, right? Now, with this in mind, how can you use your body to express God to others at home, at school, and in the community? Chances are, you haven't taken advantage of this opportunity yet, so now is the time. Bring others to God through your body.